So who wants some Bleach news? You? You want some? Okay, I'll give you some Bleach news. So, this is a bit of a weird one, so you're gonna have to bear with me because we got a lot to talk about. Because, in fact, we might actually get some original content within the Bleach anime. And yes, even though I do believe that there is going to be original content, and it seems to be likely the case due to a lot of meetings happening around Kubo's part, before and after the Club Kubo thing, by the way, just during the licensing process in general, it seems to me that obviously there's going to be some in-canon filler within the Thousand Year Blue War. But what I'm specifically talking about is an in-canon original storyline around a certain character, and if you clicked on the thumbnail, you can probably guess who it is. But before we talk about the medium that it's going to be presented in, let's get into the context of what this all started off from. So last week on Monday, Kubo did some more Q&As, and one of the Q&As was a person who spectacularly brought this up, because if I'm honest with you, I would have never have noticed if this person had brought this up. He basically asked, in a nutshell, and I'll put the original translation here, is in comparison to the other cover pages, or what I would like to call them introductory pages of characters, with this specific format, this is the specific format that I'm talking about, because yes, I already understand that there is other characters with other cover pages that have a unique difference to them, depending on their part in that current chapter, at that story, at that given point. I'm talking about specifically this format. The little box, the character, and the text. That's what's important here, because this is what is being referenced. A person in the Q&A asked that, why is Rukia's text different compared to her contemporaries? And I wouldn't have noticed. I would have assumed that the kanji or the katakana or the hiragana, I think it's just mostly katakana, is just, it's a stylistic choice. That's what I assumed. It was like the whiteness of the ice of her Zanpakuto and the blackness representing, well, maybe her shinigami, because the other shinigami also had the brush effect of katakana handwriting, right? That's what you would assume. Apparently, it's not as simple as that, because Kubo himself, he actually states that this, in fact, does have meaning. His stylistic choice does have a deeper meaning to it, and he might draw it somewhere else. So he's not going to tell us what it means, which is like, thanks, Kubo. Like, we kind of wanted to know. That would be really cool. Now, I would say a light novel. However, he says he wants to draw it, which is, I think, an important keyword to take into consideration here. And before I get into the medium and talk about why I think it is the anime and why it's very plausible that it is going to be the anime or a movie. Now, of course, I need to know more and do more research. That's just how it is. I need to understand Kubo's stylistic choices and his writing. But from all the pictures that I've saved and I'll show on screen right now, we know that the Shinigami represent the Japanese, so it's more of a Japanese type style. Every Soul Reaper has the black ink to represent their names. Then the Quincy have their own kind of font, as expected, like a Germanish kind of font. And the Aranka or Espada or Hollows, they have a Spanish-esque font to them. However, Rukia's is different. It is Japanese, and one looks unfinished. It looks like the outline to where the kanji or the katakana would be, right? So here's the interesting take. This has already been done before, and this is where it is really, really weird, because it's been done with the visors before, where it is completely black for one part and then a completely different font for another. And we even have more of a reference to this, because in the past, in the Turn Back the Pendulum, Shinji Hirako's name is in completely Shinigami black, while in the more present, when he's advised, it changes. And it's him and Hiyori that only have these at the moment, because obviously the other visors didn't have cover pages, as far as I checked. I'll go double check, and if there is, I'll just post one screen here. But that's really weird. So to say the least, that is really weird and very oddly specific. Now, do I think Rukia is a visor? No. However, I do think there is a deeper meaning that Kubo is talking about here, and I think that maybe Rukia is something else than expected. Now, I always found it strange, and maybe you guys did too, chapter 666, where Kisuke says, it's all up to you, Kuchiki and Kurosaki, or it's all up to you, Rukia and Ichigo, which was a bit weird, because it's like, well, what can Rukia do? I mean, her Bankai was stupidly strong. It was stupidly broken. It was stupidly OP. Absolute zero. She couldn't move. It came with a heavy consequence. What could Rukia really accomplish with your watch? And maybe Urahara knew something more than, realistically, than we already knew. Maybe it was to do with the Hogyoku that made her a little bit special. Maybe it's something to do with her birth lineage, if that makes sense, with maybe Hisana. You know, we don't know. And the fact that Kubo says he's going to draw this means that there has to be some kind of story to this, right? Even if it's a few pages. So, what is Ruki? This, honestly, I couldn't reach far. Well, I don't think Kubo could reach as far as this stands, but it's a pretty weird thought process that Rukia may not be fully Soul Reaper, right? It's a bit weird. So by making this video, I do want to reach out to you guys and say, hey, please, in the comment section, help me out. What do you guys take from this, right? As I said again, the text is one thing. Then it's Kisuke saying another. The Hogyoku is prevalent as well, I guess, in some sort of situation. So it's a bit of a weird one. However, because I am extra and I like to go the extra mile, and none of these that I've written down is probably has anything to do with it, I'll go and write it anyway, just to give you guys some ideas. Hypothetically, seen as the kanji is black, and it is rough and it is a brush drawing in comparison to a more cleaner, or you could say it's the outline for what would have been. You could say it maybe has something to do with the Kuchikis, right? You could say we can get more of a story on the Kuchikis, maybe Byaki's dad, maybe Koga, talking about just that situation surrounding that, maybe the death of his grandpa, who knows, because we never knew what happened to Genrei. That's his name, Genrei. We never knew what happened to him. Maybe a Kuchiki dark past that we don't know, something connected to Hisana, and maybe, I mean, the reason why I'm saying this is that because her full name is not completely finished, so, you know, is she part Kuchiki or part still Rukia? Is it because she's not a fully fledged Kuchiki clan member that the name's like that, and maybe it has something to do with a past that maybe Rukia hasn't accepted, that she's not fully devoting herself to the Kuchiki name. So it's quite plausible we could get a mini story on that. I'm always down for some Kuchiki clan lore, to be honest with you, or any noble family lore in that regard. But I don't think it is anything to do with this, but I was just doing the hypothetical. Could it be a Zanpakuto reference? As I said, if it's a clear katakana symbolism, then again, that's quite possible, because her sword is ice, so maybe it's Zanpakuto reference related. And that's basically all I got. I've already made the reference to chapter 666, so what do I think about this? I think maybe we'll get more expanded on within the Blood War. It's gotta be. If it's not getting more expanded on within the Blood War anime, then I can see a movie. Because Fade to Black really didn't do that bad at all. I think it made like 6 or 7 million in terms of sales, which is good for the average anime film. It didn't flop, it did moderately okay. It was very popular amongst fans. So I can see an anime movie pertaining around Rukia again, which is quite possible. I also see a light novel. However, if there is going to be another light novel, maybe not, I'm not convinced, then it's probably going to get animated too. If Kubo is going to draw it, not write it, but if he's going to draw it, surely there has to, it has to come in some sort of original content. For Kubo to release something to the public and draw a story, you know, maybe if he draws a picture, then that's kind of shoddy, right? But I would imagine that there is, as he says, a deeper meaning, and there has to be context to that meaning. So chances are he will draw, even if it's a few panels or a few pages, he has to release it in some way, shape or form, right? So would it be in a data book? If it's a data book, banging, because we've had data books in the past where we've had Ulquiorra had a side story in there, and we've also had Hisagi. So if we have a data book, I'm happy with that, because we get to learn, hopefully, a lot more about what Ichigo's Bankai does and a lot of other things within the Blood War. So I'm always down for that. But apart from a data book, and I think a light novel is too much for maybe something as small as possibly this. Maybe I could be wrong. But if, again, he wants to draw it, and I know he's done sketches within like the light novels, but he wants to draw this one, if that makes sense. Like, there's a difference, I think. So what else is there other than a data book? Maybe a side story in Jump, maybe. And I doubt it's going to be in Burn the Witch. So the only thing I can see is, like, he's going to draw it for the anime. Surely, right? That's the only plausible thing. Or a movie. And he can do a one shot for a movie, leading up to a movie, like manga could do in the past. So it's really all fair game here, and I really don't think it is, you know, far fetched to single original anime content out. Shueisha want the Blood War anime to to go on as long as it has. You know, a lot of series are ending in Jump, and you know, if Shueisha can have a cash cap, well, I want to say cash cow, but I don't want to make it sound as disrespectful. If they want a long-term jeopardy with Bleach, and trust me, they've got a lot of content, I can honestly see this being an original. And I'd be completely fine. I'm very interested and happy to have an original, because it's also nice to watch things without knowing what's going to happen. So that's basically the conversation slash news, if that makes sense. Tell me again your guys' thoughts in the comment section down below. Do you think this is going to be an anime original? Do you think it's going to be just a side gig in maybe Jump? And what do you think? What does this mean, Kubo? What do the sacred texts mean? But with that being said, I am going to catch you guys later. You guys, of course, have this fine day behind us, and Rukia fans, rise up, I guess. Peace out.